Today, here stands 22nd Street Park. Now, this is a beautiful place that provides asylum for many plants and native animals. But it was, once before, an ocean. This was part of the port area, but when they expanded trade and commerce, they had to add more land.
But we're not going to be talking about that. Today, we're going to be talking about the quality of the water in the wetland here at 22nd Street Park. To determine the quality, we're going to be testing for...
9 things.
Yes. 9 things. Okay, we're actually going to be testing for parameters like pH, dissolved oxygen, mineral content, and hardness. And there's this other guy that's going to tell you about nature. His name's Philo. I guess along the way we'll tell you about some of the history of the wetland, but for now, enjoy the video! So first of all, what is a wetland?
It's that! No!
Haha, well, obviously he's just stupid. But anyway, a wetland is a land area that is saturated with water, either permanently or seasonally, such that it takes on the characteristics of a distinct biosystem.
We're going to be testing for everything on this little chart. And there's about 9 things, I guess. And you got to take these tablets and you put them into each little container, but you have to make sure which one you're testing.
They said to put dissolved oxygen in first.
You guys need the packet. And one of the. Wait, where's the screws at?
Do I put it like right in the bottle?
Read it. Where are the little caps at?
Why don't you, why did you open
the
and get the packet so they could have.
Which one?
Oh, it's cut their
legs.
Yeah, you put it in the
This thing. Read it for them.
Oh, I'm wondering.
Okay. Now put it in.
Sure.
Yes, it has to overfill. Don't get it on everything. So mix it for about 4 minutes. So shake it.
It has like a...
Yeah, it will change colors.
Okay, so we're having water in a test tube, and we took the dissolved oxygen tablets and put it inside the water, and then you shake it for 4 minutes, and you're trying to see what the ppm of it is, and so far after we've done that we found out it has a 4 ppm, and then after that we're going to go to a different set and put a new type of tablet in and see what that one will be. But that's all we've done so far.
Now nature time with Philo.
Hello, I'm Philo.
Hi Philo. How did you like the wetlands?
They were nice. They were moist. I like moist things.
Did you learn anything?
I learned that the wetlands have nice places for plants to grow and for bodies to be hidden.
Did you notice all the wildlife there?
I did. They were delicious.
Now, while they're doing that, we're going to talk to these people.
Hi. So, what do you think of the experience so far? Have you learned anything yet, or what do you think?
I did learn a lot of things today, and compared to seeing this place, like, a couple years ago when I was little and I came here, it was nothing. And now it's grown so much, like, it's crazy how to see San Pedro develop every day.
Okay, so have you ever been to this park before?
No, it's actually my first time here.
So what do you think of it so far?
I think it's pretty cool because like, I learned about the history today that like before this, it was like all like messed up. And now that it's like really growing, it's really cool.
Okay, so have you learned anything yet during the on-site testing?
Oh yeah, I learned that there's some dissolved oxygen inside the water. And that with the experiments over there. And that's, pretty
much
it.
Thank you for your time.
Hi, I'm Nick.
Hi, I'm going to interview you about the wetlands. So what was the history behind it? Like, what was there before?
Okay, so until Kathy Beauregard discovered it, it was just almost like a dump. It was really bad shape because they had Union Oil tanks there from a long time ago when it used to be operational. So they had those that were left over, and they also had little tracks running through it that were part of the little red train that used to run through all of San Pedro, you know, the red car. So that's really cool. And what she did is that she completely like went in there, and she had John O'Gee and other people help her renovate it and get the city's attention to look at it and everything. So it cost about $10.5 million, but it was really worth it because now it has about 18 acres, you know, a total, just beautiful park.
So how much of the park is wetlands and how much of it is just park?
Well, the wetlands were shrinking then because, you know, they were underdeveloped and uncared for, really. So they're trying to grow and make a comeback. So the park is about 18 acres total, but the wetlands encompass about only an acre or a little bit less than that. They're growing.
How do you feel about having to pay $1.5 million of the taxpayer money into that project?
Well, although it was a high price, we've spent a lot more money on other things, including the port enhancement program, and this is really a good thing for the community because it gives a place for recreational activities like soccer and everything, and also a place for asylum for endangered species of plants and animals, and you know, the wetlands itself are pretty endangered, so I think it's a really good thing to do.
Okay, thank you, Nick.
Thank you. So far, what data have you guys collected?
We have collected the pH level, which is 7. And first we tested the dissolved oxygen, which was 4 ppm. The phosphates are 4 ppm also. And the copper was 1.5 ppm. And right now we're testing the hardness. And we have to keep dissolving tablets until it turns blue. And once it turns blue, we have to multiply the number of tablets by 40 to get the hardness level.
And we're on that.
So what would the hardness indicate?
The hardness indicates that how healthy and fresh the water is.
Does water qualify as fresh water?
Yeah, because we're already on 9, and that's a lot.
And there's no iron or chlorine,
and the pH is 7, so that's good.
So it's more basic than
acidic? Yes. Or it's like the middle.
It's like the middle.
It's neutral.
That's it.
Again, with Milo.
Hello, it's Philo again. This is a tree. Its name is Bob. Bob Barker. Trees like this one are very good for animals to hide and sleep in. They also provide oxygen, which we do need to breathe. Wetlands like the one you've seen today have given trees like this sanctuary, and for just pennies a day, you too can help save these poor trees. It's okay, Bob.
Okay, so what would the experiments show that you guys performed in the wetland?
We first got the water, which was like actually really filthy. You could see like little creatures moving in it, but that doesn't mean it's not fresh. So what we did was like get the water, and it came with these tiny pills that we put in. And what was kind of a hassle was looking for the hardness. We had to keep on mixing it until it turned blue. So we put like at least like 9 pills in there, and then it eventually turned blue.
And from the results from last year, how would they differ from this year?
Oh, actually no change at all, which is really good. So the water's doing good.
Well, you heard it. The water is good. Now to end this video, let's check on Philo.
I am one with nature.
Philo, did you take your medication?
Bob provides me with sustenance. It's so beautiful. The flies are dancing all around us.
Okay, bye.
Oh, Dana, open up your thing and I'll connect it.
Okay.
Do you want me to start meeting?
I have no clue.
This is what I listen to in 7th period.
People over there talk.
Star Wars.
Then tablet into the water, and we're trying to sleep.
Can you guys not? And then. Sega!
Sega!
I don't like that.
You're still here? It's over. Go home. Go.